Why am I trying to pretend to be something I'm not? You know? I'm not a good kid.
Dad, I'm not a normal guy.
I don't fit in. I'm weird. I'm different from everybody else.
There's something wrong with me,
Jeff,
I think.
Jeff, just come on.
I'm serious, Dad. There's things that I want to do, and
there's stuff that I've done that I don't know. I think I should tell you about. About some of the fantasies that I've had.
Okay, so wait. Is this sex stuff?
Yeah. That's part of it.
You know what? Hey. So I'm sorry. I just got an idea. Mm-hmm. mm-hmm. Ohio State.
Oh.
We're going to get him in Ohio State. We are. We're going to get you into Ohio State. Uh-huh. Yeah, I'll even pay for the first semester.
Oh.
Got a great science program. What do you think?
I think that sounds good.
Good.
That's decided, then that's what we're gonna do.
Stand right up.
Your Honor, it is over now. This has never been a case of trying to get free. I didn't ever want freedom. Frankly, I wanted death for myself.
When I say the name Dahmer, I suspect one person comes to your mind, and that is, of course, the serial killer, Jeffrey Dahmer. He is the Milwaukee man who admits to murdering 17 young men. When police arrested Jeffrey Dahmer in 1991, they found dismembered bodies in his apartment. Later, in a trial to determine his sentence, victims' relatives were devastated to learn it was worse than that. Some of the victims suffered for days in Dahmer's chamber of horrors. Sometimes he practiced cannibalism. Most victims were gay, many of them black. The motive behind the crimes, sex, sometimes before he killed, sometimes after. Now Jeffrey Dahmer's in prison, serving more than 900 years.
When I sat down opposite Jeffrey Dahmer for this interview, I wondered what he would tell me. What I found was that he volunteered details that may be difficult to hear, and we should warn you that it is not suitable for children.
Picking the victims from the streets and getting them to his house and killing them.
I know that this man, he kills people and then he keeps the body parts in his freezer.
What do you think about that? Does that make you nervous? Do you worry about that?
Yeah.
Why?
Because it's real disgusting, and you think maybe sometime he just might come to you.
We banned them from the news, which is too bad because we like to keep them up on things, but nothing like this.
Imagine her anguish upon learning what her son had done.
I knew that I'd done a good job as a parent.
She and Joyce are now planning a book to counter this one written by Jeff's father.
He's not what the public perceives him to be only.
Court documents show Dahmer's parents went through a bitter divorce during his junior and senior years. A former classmate felt something tragic was going to happen.
And I remember that kid that, you know, somebody should have helped and didn't.
I frankly wished I could put him down like you do a sick animal.
We do not have an explanation for Jeff's behavior.
He is a human being that has committed terrible crimes. And if we don't learn from that, then he has not served his purpose here on Earth, nor have we.
The apartment building where Dahmer killed his victims has been torn down. But that has done little to ease the pain of the victims' families. Police didn't care when their loved ones were reported missing because they were black or homosexual. After a Milwaukee Police Department investigation, two officers were fired. One was reprimanded.
The fact that Milwaukee police officers saw the missing boy and Jeffrey Dahmer together,
They had the boy and Dahmer in their hands, but returned the 14-year-old to Dahmer's custody. Police responded while Dahmer was dragging the boy back to his apartment.
I was still trying to tell them what I had seen. They was like, that they had this, well, this one cop told me that he had been a detective for 8 years and he ain't need no amateur poking in his business and for me to leave before he take me downtown.
And he was the one that informed me that this was not a child involved in this, that this was a homosexual relationship, and that the matter was taken care of.
It's a intoxicated boyfriend of another boyfriend.
Well, how old was this child?
It wasn't a child, it was an adult.
The question is a basic one. Did the department blow a number of opportunities to catch this man before more people lost their lives?
In reality, people with this background, they're very unalarming. They don't strike the nerve in a policeman that some of the more abrasive criminals do.
And then we have to look at why it is that he was allowed to get away with this so long. What is it in the society that puts such a low value on minority youth, hatred and fear of homosexual youth?
We have a big problem. I think that our neighborhood is marked. Okay, not black, white, it's marked because we're in the location that we live in. When they hear that we're having problems in our area, they it seems like they just kind of take their time.
Now why, when this happens in the inner city, does all of a sudden it's not a big deal?
It just hurts me that it's something like this that has to take place for the other people who don't know for us to start talking about.
What we need is a command structure that has a consistency across communities. They don't want to treat white people the same as they treat gay people and black people and brown people and yellow people,
right,
and red people.
And
I don't want you to tell me that it's getting better. I want to see a command structure in place because I know that can happen.
Let me respond to one thing that bothers me about this whole show, and it's the role of the media.
It's real people that have been affected by the crimes that have been committed here.
You woke up at what, 8 this morning?
Right.
And then you cleaned up your apartment really nicely so you could show us what it looks like?
Yeah, I want you to come over if you feel like it. I haven't done any dusting or vacuuming or anything. I do that on Sundays.
Who is this?
Yeah.
That's Cousin Jeff.
Yes. Looks like a bunch of satisfied people sitting around here.
What's going on?
Get in the car, David. We're leaving.
Well,
I just need to get away, get my head together. Okay, I'm sorry. That's what's happening.
You can't just leave me here.
Cut the shit, Jeff.
No. Don't leave. Why does everybody always want to leave me?
Don't call.
Mr. Dahmer, your wife had an overdose.
Who called the ambulance?
Your son did.
Hey, Jeff. It was good calling the ambulance.
Okay.
There's this game I made when I was a kid. It's called Infinity Land.
These are mine now. She gave them to me. No!
So, your soldier starts at that end.
You don't know who I am, do you? You knew my brother. Sounds like?
No, I don't think so.
You got arrested for it, dude. We're not sleeping together or nothing.
We'll see.
Alright, fuck you. I'm out of here.
You should know, getting arrested doesn't suddenly make you guilty of everything.
I've never been arrested.
I need you to lower your voice, okay? And if you keep calling us all the time, how are we gonna know when it's an emergency? 911 is a resource, okay?
I am saying somebody is being killed. Do you get that?
My soldier starts from here.
What do you love to do? What's your dream? I want to know what your dream is.
I think that's just something people say. I don't think everybody gets to have a dream. You're the one who told me I need to get out in the world. I don't like it.
Dad, can I please come home?
Hey, Dad. Let's go home. She saw I brought guys home. She didn't want to accept what that meant. I think she just didn't want to know. Each time you roll the dice, your soldier travels along the spirals.
When you said on the phone there was a murder investigation, I thought someone might have tried to murder him. What the heck are you doing with a mannequin, Jeff?
Just did it on a dare.
So what were you doing at the State Fair, Jeff? Exposing yourself?
I was just being outside. I didn't know anyone could see.
Why did you molest that boy, Jeff?
I didn't molest him. All I did was take some photos.
Don't bullshit me.
I'm telling you, I didn't even know how old he was.
Why the kid said you molested him? Why would a kid lie about
it? I don't know. I don't know why. People are out to get me, Dad. I don't understand it either.
And the first person to get to Infinity Land wins the game.
How do you do this? Why do you do that? Hey. Hey, wake up.
Wake up!
No. No. Oh, no. No. You're never gonna talk to me again. Really? You idiot! You fucking idiot!
Compulsion had just taken over completely at that point. I wasn't even trying to stop it. It just got really easy is the problem.
But there's a catch. If your guy gets too close to mine,
kept waiting to get caught. Never did. I watched the news. There was never any story about anybody going missing or anything like that.
And why do you think that was?
You didn't have anything weird in there? Gay stuff? Like I said, we're boyfriends. Yeah. Just gets a little fiery.
Yeah, I sure don't know.
Fiery because what? He's Asian?
Yeah.
I should have pressed him harder to find out what was really going on. But the truth is, he made me uncomfortable. And I really didn't. No.
He disappears into the vortex.
They made a comic book about you. Did you know? Your biggest fan, Alice.
A fucking comic book. I mean, well, now we know where the fault lies. The whole culture.
I don't like this one.
My fans do.
Crude attempt at lobotomy that none of its victims survived.
Why he gets to go on national TV to tell his side of the story?
I hear you, girl, but maybe if we can understand what motivated him.
This is not some Halloween story.
I know.
This is my life. I've kept this
single faith I have. Just can't.
I knew you was up to something, Jeff Dahmer. And I called you, and I told you over and over a million times that something was going on, and you know what you did? Y'all did nothing. Nothing.
You go first.
I feel for you, ma'am. Truly, I do. You want your truth as a mother to be heard. I understand that. But maybe now is time for you to listen to somebody else's truth.
We had one rule going into this from Ryan, that it would never be told from Dahmer's point of view. As an audience, you're not really sympathizing with him. You're not really getting into his plight. You're more sort of watching it, you know, from the outside. It's called the Jeffrey Dahmer story, but it's not just him and his backstory. It's the repercussions. It's the society. It's this how society and our system failed to stop him multiple times.
Hey everybody, so we're sitting here on this lovely afternoon talking to the cast of Dahmer, Monster, the Jeffrey Dahmer story. I've been working on this, I think, for close to a decade. It took me a while to get it made. And I believe we did several months of casting, and I think we must have read 100 guys. And there were many great contenders. And I just kept thinking, if only Evan would do this. And obviously I've known Evan since he was 17. He auditioned for me for American Horror Story. I said this before, but I jokingly cast him because he looked like Jessica Lange. And then he played her son. And then he showed up on the first day and did something so amazing that we went back and rewrote the season for him and his talent. So I called Evan up and said, I don't know how you're going to feel about this, but I'm going to send you these scripts.
I really struggled with whether to dive into it or not.
Yeah.
But you you said watch the Dateline interview with Stone Phillips.
Yeah.
And I did that, and I was just really transfixed by how he spoke about what he did, and confused by it, and wanted to dive into the psychology of that, and ultimately said yes, but it was really a struggle on whether I should do that or not.
But it was hard for you. God. I mean, I could see that. I think we could see that it was definitely a hard project to take on and be in that person's mind all that time.
Yeah.
I mean,
yeah, it was very hard.
I was worried, you know, as your, you know, stepmother and as an older actress, to see somebody that was clearly in pain.
Your commitment to this role was so incredibly impressive and powerful and truly mesmerizing. I mean, honestly.
Thank you.
And I have worked with De Niro and Brando and Pacino, and you're wow. Right up there.
In 10 episodes, we're always pushing around the focus. Like, whose fault is this? It's systemic racism. It's homophobia. But I love the scene where Richard, after Jeffrey is convicted, goes to you and says, it's my fault.
And may I say, I mean, the guy is freaking brilliant in this. He's just brilliant. But him standing there looking at me, that's what made it happen.
Yeah.
Nothing else, nothing. I didn't, you know, think about it, prepare, and that. Just, I looked at him and I knew that it was going to be okay.
Now, I've been looking everywhere to find out who's responsible for all this, blaming everybody except myself. And it's me. I'm the one to blame.
Hey, okay. You don't have to say that.
Okay, shut up, Jeff. Please, just listen to me. Listen to me. It's me. I did this to you. All that stuff with the dead animals, I shouldn't have done that. I shouldn't have showed you how to do that. And your fantasies about killing people and stuff. I should have made you feel like you could tell me about that stuff. You know? And you didn't feel safe.
How did you capture him? What did you do?
I sort of studied how he moved, and you know, he had a very straight back. He didn't move his arms when he walked, so.
And you wore lead weights around your hands at times, correct?
I did. In the beginning, it was important for me to get kind of how that felt. As we were shooting, I let that go, but I did that. And in the beginning, I wore wardrobes, shoes and jeans and glasses, and I had a cigarette in my hand at all times, just trying to get all of these external second nature. So I wasn't thinking about it when we were shooting. I worked with dialect coaches and then created this 45-minute audio composite that I listened to every day to stay in the accent, but also to really get into the mindset for the day and all the scenes we were shooting, and tried to understand what he was thinking and going through. I just tried to stay in it because it was too hard to go in and out of it.
And then the scene between Evan and Niecy, which is the sandwich scene. And I never understood why that was my favorite scene, but it felt Shakespearean when we were writing it. And of course, Jeffrey Dahmer apparently did this to many people in the complex, giving them the gift of sandwiches.
Take back the complaint. I made you a sandwich.
What are you doing there? Huh?
Where?
In that damn apartment. The smells, the power tools going all hours of the night.
I'm just building something.
Well, what about the screaming?
What's screaming?
I hear screaming coming from your apartment.
Sometimes I have nightmares.
What about that little Asian boy?
I don't know. We broke up.
And what about Dean Vaughn? You was talking to him in the hallway, then I never saw him after that. Tell you what. You tell me where he is, I'll take back the complaint.
I've known Evan for a long time. And I find Evan to be, in real life, an absolute delight. He's funny. We joke. He has Thanksgiving. My kids are sitting on his knee. We've laughed. And the interesting thing about him as an actor is when he's working, he's so dedicated. I wouldn't call it method acting because it almost, I don't even know how to describe it, but that person goes away.
People would ask me, what is he like? I'm like, I don't know. Because we did not connect at all during the filming. And at first I felt some kind of way because I felt like, well, who doesn't like me? I'm a very likable lady, you know? And then I realized, I'm like, oh, this is his process. I'm so sorry. And my, you know, and I was like, sure. let me allow him. Cause I'm like, good morning. And he's very stoic. And I'm like, I said, good morning, Evan. Now what's going on? How was your weekend? You know, and he's just like, lady, get from over here. Cause it's not going to happen. You know what I mean? I can't, you know, love you or warm to you and still go in this scene and do what I need to do. I got to stay over here. So I met him the other night and I'm like, oh, he's so nice. He's so charming. But yeah,
I told you.
I think to me, it was just really important to do 120% the entire way through. I know, Richard, you were nervous about me burning out, and but I really wanted to do that. I wanted to see what happened with that, how that felt. It felt like the material deserved it. You know, I put in so much negativity and darkness to portray the character that I just thought, okay, once this is done, all that goes away, and I have to get back into the light and start filling myself back up with comedies. And I said it the other night, but you told me one day I was really struggling, and your grandmother has this saying, and I'll let you say it because I don't want to mess it up.
He was struggling one day, and I said, my grandmama always says, one thing I told Evan was, she always said, hang tough till you get enough. And when you get enough, still hang tough.
I texted Evan the other day and I was like, hey, are you okay? You know, just to check in, you know, because I thought the same thing. I literally was like, oh my God, this is so many hours and hours and hours and hours, uh-huh, weeks and months of being in this headspace. And, you know, he seems to be good. He's got a good outlet for everything. And it's really mesmerizing to watch. He's truly a pro. The only time I've seen the eyes of the individual change, because we've seen like people put on weight or take off weight, mm-hmm, you know, or change their bodies or put on prosthetics to look like certain characters, but like their eyes are still there, you know, mm-hmm, that is still so-and-so's eyes. And then when I saw Evan in this, it's just dull.
Yeah.
Like this sad dullness that I was like, that's just not him.
I was his dad. Mm-hmm. I wasn't one of those other. I was his father. And so, yeah, I talked to him off camera on purpose because mm-hmm, he was different with me. He was different with me than he was with everybody else. And I felt it when I did it, but when I saw it, that's when I really said, okay, yeah, he's different with his dad.
I can't believe he's always playing these horrible characters because he's so not like that. I said, you must be so nice because you get your dark side out and you get paid for it. I don't know.
My favorite scene would be getting killed, because when Evan killed me, I made him great character. Yeah, a little backstage information for you.
One of the very first acting classes I ever went to, the coach had to stand on a chair and jump off of it. And he was like, that's what acting is supposed to feel like. And it's crazy because I really did chase after these ideas of what I thought maybe it should be. And particularly in a scene with Richard Jenkins in episode 4 at the diner, I was really, really struggling to get what I wanted to do there. And he was very helpful in sort of explaining, re-explaining that you have to go with what's in the moment, regardless of what it is, and if it feels wrong and you're terrified and, oh my God, what is it going to be? I don't know. He goes, it's so much better to go with what is in the moment. So that was a huge lesson for me, and I carry that with me throughout shooting. And he said you can really feel like you're free-falling, and that reminded me of that very first acting class. I started when I was 15, and I was playing around a lot and partying and having fun and not really applying myself. And then all of a sudden I thought, shit, I'm getting older. I need to really start focusing on this. And I did that. And once I did that, I started to work more. I started to actually work and get jobs and then get into the minutiae of the characters and the parts and acting. And what is it? And this is so weird what we're doing with the camera and all these different things and really breaking it down and trying to figure out what it is. And now I'm just completely obsessed and in love with it. And I can't stop. It's really amazing. So yeah, I always said maybe don't stay out at the party and do those extra lines. Maybe go home and memorize.
You're mumbling about it.
Wow, I'm just thinking aloud, you know.
Okay. I like that. I like that.
So, what's next?
Next.
What's gonna keep you from spending all your nights in the shadow of those guys?
So do you want to be Johnny Depp or Paul Giamatti? Or does it matter?
Neither. I don't know. I want to be me. I want to do the best job I can do and try to do that. Yeah, I've been trying to be other people for quite a while, and now I'm just going to try to be me and see what happens. Mm. Fuck.
You're very good.
Yeah.
Shut up, Evan. Hotel rocks, man.
Hotel's good.
Hotel's fucking great. Yeah.
It's true.
Totally true.
It's true.
It's totally true.
What's happening?
No, it's on him. It's on him.
Wait. My dad's wife. My dad's new wife.
Let's take it back to yeah, let's take
wait, that's good stuff. We could win with that. Dad? Dad?
Oh, Jesus. Are you okay?
Baby, I'm yours.
I started watching a lot of horror movies. A lot of the times I will jump, especially when it's that quiet moment, and then bah, you know, that still scares me. Maybe cut that out. I don't know. Let's just say
nothing in the world can drive me away. Every day you hear me say, baby,
Stay weird. Thank you.